I hear a lot of noise upstairs, and those are my neighbors who are not very considerate. Hi, so this is the Q&A I've been wanting to film for the longest time, but have never gotten the chance to do so. Also, this is my plushie, and my thousands of plushies in that corner. Wait, I have another one. Where's my other one? I have two! Is it missing an ear? Oh my god, crazy. Oh my god, I had it in a different way. Oh my god, no wonder. I thought I accidentally ripped its ear off while I was sleeping. Okay, now it's it. But, hi. I'm finally filming this Q&A. Oh, and don't mind my shirt. This is not my shirt. This is really not my shirt. But it was given to me. I do have the questions on my phone. I'm only gonna be answering 5. I'm gonna make this a series. First question. Someone asked me, can editing be difficult at times? Okay. So I'm gonna go about this one of two ways. So I have YouTube editing, and then I have Instagram editing. But when it comes to YouTube editing, it's not entirely bad. I mean, sure, I get copyrighted because of the music I choose, but what can I do about it? When it comes to YouTube editing, it's not entirely bad, but more like it takes time for you to edit certain clips and then grab certain music, and it's okay. So I think the longest I've edited a video is either there's 3 videos in total. There's my Cal State LA fall semester, my Cal State LA spring semester, and then my 19th birthday bash. All 3 videos took me quite a while for me to edit and film. There was like many delays with those 3, but the shortest time I had to edit a video was, I want to say, maybe my San Diego Las Vegas trip. I think that was it. I think that was like the shortest time I edited a video. And then Instagram wise, so I will not be exposing my editing account because, yeah, I will not be doing that. Okay, we are not gonna go there. Editing for Instagram. Okay, let me tell you the software that I use. For my YouTube videos, I used to use iMovie, but now I use Final Cut Pro. It's a mix between iMovie and Final Cut Pro. And then Instagram edits, I use After Effects, and that is definitely okay. Now, I remember there was like some sort of delay with After Effects. I remember I was working on an edit, and it deleted like my entire project, even though I saved it. Like, After Effects is known to corrupt at many times. You hold my hand, the hours part from where I stand, don't make my mark. Don't hold me back with soft and soft. The way I act will hurt your heart. Editing can be difficult at times. It really depends on if I'm in a good mood, if I have time on my hands, or if I'm just, why do you choose your major? Okay, for those of you who do not know, my major in college is TV and film production. Now, I do have my reasons for this. I have just a very short story for you guys. Originally, I was going into college I have my major determined during my junior year, I remember. I was very focused on this major junior year. But my dad said I needed to get my major figured out by junior year, so that senior year I could just like, you know? I had my major as animal biology. I do not regret it. I joined a media class junior year of high school, And in short terms, it was called MTV. Yeah, I'm not kidding. Moral of the story, I was in junior year of high school, had a major focus on animal biology, and thought, okay, I'm probably gonna go to UC Davis for this. I was wrong. So, I went from animal biology, going to UC Davis, to TV and film production, to Cal State LA. Oh, quick disclaimer, Cal State LA was not my first choice, okay? It did not focus much on film at Cal State LA, but I had no other choice. During junior and senior year, I took this media class and I did a lot of film projects. I did PSAs, I did short films, I did music videos, I even did a commercial. I did a commercial on on Vans. I'm not kidding. I will insert the link somewhere so that you guys can watch it. Most of my family knows that commercial. Like, it's in the back of their hands. So I told my dad that I was gonna go into TV and film production, and he was like very surprised, because even though I was a creative person, he didn't think that was gonna happen. That is why I chose my major, because I did not want to be like spooked by animal biology. Favorite makeup product? What is my favorite makeup product? I say it's a tie between, like, if it's a makeup product in general, then I'd say eyeliner, because I don't know, it makes me stand out. How? I don't know. But if it has to be like a certain product, like a certain brand, if it's like a certain type of product, like what kind of eyeshadow, I would say Morphe, just because it has like, my group fell. Okay. The only Morphe palette I have is the James Charles palette.
Hi, sisters!
I'm not kidding. I wish I was, but I'm not kidding. So, I wasn't kidding, because this is a James Charles palette. But my friend gave me this palette because she said she wasn't gonna use it as much, and she knew that I was gonna use it, because number one, I'm obsessed with colorful eye palettes, and number two, I like James Charles. I like his looks. Oh, don't mind the gigantic mess. I haven't gotten the chance to clean this, but that's okay. Oh, funny story. My boyfriend was very tempted to get me this palette for Christmas, but luckily I told him that I already got the palette. Dream wedding / no, I didn't really put much thought into this. I know a lot of people would already have their dream wedding / honeymoon. I didn't really put much thought into my dream wedding. The only thing I had in mind was my dream dress. My dream dress wouldn't be like those, the fishtail, I would have like a flowy type of dress.
Try to make me laugh, and nothing else to change today. You didn't mean to say I love you.
It would just be like super magical, super just like full of glitter. Okay, I want my wedding dress to be full of glitter. I think my dream wedding, I'm debating whether or not to do it in I really don't know. I either want to do my honeymoon at Disney World or Hawaii. Maybe New York, I'm not too sure. Last question, favorite memory with my boyfriend? Ooh. Now, I have a lot of memories. I want to say when both of us went to, not for the very first time together, you know, that was our very first time hanging out, as our very first time, just like being ourselves, having a fun summer. Yeah, it was pretty fun, and I was actually thrilled because the same day we hung out for the first time was the same day he called me his best friend, and I was like, wow. I'm not gonna lie, I felt accomplished because I've never had guy best friends before, only like girl best friends. So that was like a huge moment for me. And then when we got together, I think my favorite memory, God, there are so many memories with him, I can't think of a memory of mine would be like the first time we went to Disneyland together. Yeah. The first time we went to Disneyland together, it was like the day after Halloween, so we were kind of bummed that the Halloween decorations were no longer there. But that's okay. That's okay because they were starting to put up Christmas decorations. Like, we were in Toontown and we were taking a photo, and they already had the garments up, they had the ornaments up, and you know, if it's not Halloween, it's Christmas, okay? Because Halloween and Christmas at Disneyland is pretty much like a big, big deal. Another favorite memory of mine is, oh my god, I was so gullible of this, I'm not gonna lie. It was like maybe a week before my birthday, and supposedly my boyfriend was talking to my mom at the time through text message, and he was trying to plan out a pre-birthday dinner with all my friends, and I had like no idea. So I was very surprised to see all my friends there, and it was just like I've never felt that much loved in all my life, to be honest with you. I mean, yeah, my family throws like parties and we have dinners together, but like I don't think I've ever had like a significant other do that big of a thing for me, and I didn't think he was able to pull it off. I was just blown away. Sure, we waited like 2 hours just to be seated, but it was definitely worth it because we all caught up because I know my best friend still goes to the same school as me. My other two best friends, one goes to Fullerton and one goes to San Marcos. So I don't get to see the other two as often as I do with my LA buddy. But that was the only time that my best friend from San Marcos had to come home, because during that same weekend, it was her birthday too. So it definitely worked out in the end. I still can't believe it. We waited 2 hours just to be seated. That was just crazy. I know, another favorite moment. Oh my god, I have so many favorite moments. I can't, like, it was his birthday, and you know, we had the entire day planned. We were gonna go eat, and then we were gonna go to Disneyland for his birthday, and I was like, That was actually the first time he's seen me with my bangs. I'm not gonna lie. That was the first time he's seen me with my bangs. And it was just... I can't believe it. So I remember... And I should have filmed this. I regret not filming it to this day. But we were at IHOP and I had to use the bathroom. You know, just to like... Just to go. Side note, you know me, I don't usually go to the bathroom, okay? I told him I was gonna go to the bathroom, when in reality, I was gonna try to find an employee and tell them that it was his birthday, just so he could be surprised. So, I did that, and that was social anxiety. I kid you not. I was panicking while in the bathroom. I was like, how do I ask someone about their birthday? How do I do it? I was panicking. And so after we finished eating, the employees were... Okay, we were in this booth, and the kitchen was like right here. Luckily, I was facing the kitchen, so I know what's going on. And I was looking at the kitchen, and there were like a bunch of employees gathered up. They were waiting for me to give like some sort of signal as to like when we were done. So we're just like sitting there, we're just waiting. The employees come out and they sing him a happy birthday, and he gives me this look like,
what have you done?
I felt so proud of myself, because you know me, I have social anxiety. I was never gonna be able to do that.
So, how'd you like it?
So after breakfast, we went to Disneyland, and you know, we were just having the time of our lives. You know, we were just doing what we gotta do. That was a pretty great time. I've had a lot of memories with him, but I think, you know what, I'm probably still gonna make like a lot of more memories with him, and I don't know which ones are gonna be like the top notch. I don't know yet. But we are gonna find out someday. But that is all I have for this Q&A episode. I will try to film another episode sometime soon. Hopefully I will get more questions asked by them, because I want to answer more questions. I do want to tell more stories. If you're new to this channel, hi, I'm Angie, and you should definitely check out my content and subscribe, because yeah, I try to film whenever I can. So it would be greatly appreciated if I get like suggestions of what I shall upload. But hope to see you all in the next video with this little guy, especially because I love him.